Hey guys, on this episode of Ristretto, I would like to talk about a really cool device I obtained recently. It's been a few weeks, and it's really been eye-opening and pretty cool to get involved in this device and this project. So I recently got my hands on the R1 by Rabbit. Now, many of you might not know what this is. It's basically an AI device for $199. You can teach it things, it learns things, it answers questions, it takes pictures. It gives you an analysis of what it's seeing. It also turns pictures into AI art. It takes shopping lists for you. It gives you reminders. There's just a whole lot you can do with this thing. I'm just so stoked to feature this on my channel. So I do have a limited series coming up called Rabbit Talk, where I'm going to dig into this thing a little bit more. But for this episode of Ristretto, I wanted to give you my first take on this thing. I've had it for a couple of weeks, and I cannot wait to show this thing to you. What is the Rabbit R1?
Searching for Rabbit R1 device. The Rabbit R1 is a compact AI-powered personal assistant device developed by Rabbit Inc. It runs on Rabbit OS, which is based on the Android open source project. The device is designed to be a versatile AI companion that can assist with various tasks such as answering questions, playing music, ordering services like Uber or DoorDash, and more. It features a voice-first interface, making it easy to integrate into everyday life. The Rabbit R1 was released on January 9th, 2024, and is available for purchase without a subscription, priced at $199. Despite some mixed reviews, it aims to offer a unique blend of functionality and convenience in a portable form.
So guys, I'm stoked about this thing. I'm not sure if you can see this here, but there is a scroll wheel here that you use to get around. There's also one button over here, and that's pretty much it. There's a lot this thing can do. We're going to dive into some of those this episode and give you my overall first impressions of this thing. So come on back to Ristretto. So what exactly is the Rabbit R1? And what can you do with this thing? Well, I'm going to do my best to tell you what I do with this thing. Let's get started. Welcome back, you guys. Ballistic Coffee Boy here, your host. As I said, I've had the Rabbit R1 now for a few weeks. It's been a really fun experience. Before I got this thing, I watched a ton of videos about it to kind of be prepared on, you know, what exactly to do with this thing. So first and foremost, I love this device for taking notes. It takes notes for me. It reminds me of things. It also learns about me. It learns what my favorite colors are, for instance. Hey, Rabbit, just FYI, my favorite colors are red and blue.
Thanks for sharing your favorite colors, Brian. Red and blue are great choices. If there is anything specific you would like to do with those colors, like finding products or themes, just let me know.
So what else can you do with the Rabbit R1? Well, let's look at a few things. So the cool thing is there's actually a teach mode, and you could actually go and teach it additional things, and there's connections you can make between music, ride sharing, and food. just to start. Pretty neat. So Rabbit can also order food for you as well. You can also have it order an Uber for you. You just tie those accounts up to that. There are just a few that are connected right now, but over time they're hoping to connect more as well. So one of the cool things about the Rabbit R1 as well is you can take pictures. So let's go and switch over to the camera by clicking this button twice. And what that does, it shows you the camera here. Now you can kind of click it to take a picture, and then Rabbit will take that and make a cool UI photo out of it. So you can also switch the camera. Let's get this thing on. And you can switch the camera. Hey Rabbit, here's a picture of me.
Let me take a look. Let's see what we've got here. Thanks for sharing the picture, Brian. You look great with the cap and the smile. If there is anything specific you would like to do with the photo, or if you have any questions, just let me know.
So what Rabbit will do is they will actually turn that into AI generated image, which is pretty cool. It can also, you could show Rabbit food you have in your fridge. It could suggest recipes. You could show Rabbit clothes you have. It could suggest an outfit. So there's a lot this thing can do, and a lot it can learn as well. So, and it's very, very, very neon orange, which I like. It stands out. So a lot of people instantly ask me, where does it store your information whenever you tell the Rabbit R1 something? Well, good question. It takes it out on the internet. It stores it somewhere called the Rabbithole that you set up when you first get your device. It is pretty secure. And this is where it stores all your questions, all your pictures. And it takes this and creates AI images as well. And this is where it puts all your notes and reminders too. So pretty cool. So you heard that right. There's no subscription. This does reach out to the internet to provide information, and pretty neat. So this device was actually made to be an AI companion, you know, and I think it's pretty darn cool. I cannot wait to get more into this device on my series Rabbit Talk that's going to be airing soon on my channel. Just a lot of fun. And yeah, it's been very eye-opening, really, to use this thing. So one of the cool things about this too is it plays music. Like I asked it to play some pop music from Spotify, which you can also attach, as well as iTunes, and it plays that. So you can go to the settings here, get more information about that. There is all kinds of stuff here in the settings. If you roll downwards, you go to the R-Cade, which is a new feature. You can play and earn carrots. So you earn carrots as you do things on the R1, and you can go in the R-Cade. As you can see here, I have him outfitted with a cowboy hat and a piece of hay, which is neat. So you go in here and play the game, which is really neat. And it gives you more functionality to your device. And you shake it to open it. Extra, extra. Neat. So there's a little hat there. So I'm just going to collect it because I like what he's wearing right now. So pretty neat. So there are lots of things in there that you can collect, and it appears on the screen. So that's pretty neat. There is just a lot you could do with this device. As I said, it really is up to you. You could train it to actually go out on the internet and do things for you. There is a Learn app as well, and you can train it to do things, which I think is just amazing. So really, the future is limitless with this thing. There were lots of videos out there in the beginning about how terrible the R1 was. People didn't understand, but really they didn't know how to ask it questions. You do have to ask it questions in a certain way for it to do things, and that's part of your learning with the device too. But overall, you guys, I think this is a really cool device. As I said, it even plays music. Hey Rabbit, play me some classical music on Spotify.
music going now.
Awesome. And yeah, it's just an amazing device. So you can tie Spotify or iTunes to it, and it will play that music for you and show you the cover art. Hey, Rabbit, turn the music off. Just a really cool device. So let me know what you guys think about the Rabbit R1. I think it's freaking amazing. I cannot wait to delve more into this on my channel. Definitely stay tuned for that. And you know, I want to be a part of the future of technology, and I'm a big techie, as you know. I love my gadgets. This fits right up my alley. Let me know if it fits up yours too. That sounded bad, but pretty cool device. As I said, $199, no subscription required. You can connect it to your Wi-Fi. You can also put in a SIM card in it to attach it to your phone, but that's not required. But that gives you the portability to take it anywhere. I have actually taken this to Starbucks and gotten on their Wi-Fi and used it. So there are other options for using it too, when you're not attached to your Wi-Fi. So let me know what you guys think about the Rabbit R1. I think it's a cool device. I'm glad to be a part of this experience for sure. This AI learning, I think it's really fun and really cool. There is literally so much you could do with this thing. You can ask it for the median house prices in a certain area. You can have it look up airline tickets, all kinds of cool stuff. The sky really is the limit. Hey, Rabbit, can you start a shopping list?
On it. Saving a note about shopping list. I have started a shopping list for you. Feel free to add items whenever you need.
Hey, Rabbit, add to the note shopping list. Apples, bread, cheese, and bananas.
On it. Saving a note about shopping list. I have added apples, bread, cheese, and bananas to your shopping list. If you need to add more items, just let me know.
So there's a lot you can do with this device, guys. It's pretty much limitless what you could do. You could even go in the terminal and type in something if you don't feel like talking, but pretty cool. So essentially, it takes lists, it sets alarms, it could order food for you, it could grab information from the internet and read that to you, it could tell you what's going on locally as well. Hey, Rabbit, what's going on this weekend in Albuquerque?
Give me a moment to look that up for you. Searching for events in Albuquerque, January 19th, 2021-2025. Here is what is happening in Albuquerque this weekend. 1. Albuquerque Comic Con. Dates, January 19th to 21st.
So yeah, as you can see, she has problems saying stuff sometimes, but she will get the information for you. So she was talking about Comic-Con being here. So, and a long list of things too. And this all gets stored in the rabbit hole in the cloud in your account. So it can refer back to the information too. And you could actually refer to those things, for instance. Hey, Rabbit, tell me about the Comic-Con going on in Albuquerque this weekend.
Looking for places? Albuquerque Comic Con details. Location, Albuquerque. Convention Center, 401 2nd Street. Northwest, Albuquerque, New Mexico. Dates, January 19th to January 21st, 2025. Phone, 505-768-4575. Rating, 4.3 out of 5 from 1,439 reviews. Event highlights. Cosplay.
So any issues with this thing so far? Yes. Sometimes you'll ask it something and it won't respond because you're not asking in the right format. Also, the battery life could be a lot better. They do have improvements quite a bit, but the battery life kind of stinks.
Costume.
So I'm going to turn that off, but you get the idea. So pretty neat, you guys. Let me know what you think about the Rabbit R1. As I said, there's a lot you can do with it. Really, as I said, the sky is the limit. I'll be going over this more on my channel, on my series Rabbit Talk, coming up soon on my channel. So stay tuned for that limited series. Awesome, guys. So definitely, I would recommend this thing if you like tech, if you like gadgets, if you like the idea of AI, if you want a personal assistant, if you want to dabble around with something new, this might be for you. If you're not sure what it's for, I wouldn't get it. All right, guys, thanks so much for watching Ristretto. We'll see you next time with some more Atari stuff, with some more tech and other goodies. We'll see you next time. Bye now. Bye, Rabbit.
Goodbye, Brian. If you need anything else, feel free to reach out. Have a great day.
This is a Gem 1 device, so hopefully more iterations of this coming. This is just the early days, so I'm excited to see where this takes us for sure, and to be on this ride with the Rabbit. And really, I mean, who knows where this is going to go in the future. So I like being on the cutting edge of technology. I think this is very cool. Let me know what you guys think. I am definitely all in on the Rabbit R1.